what mystery lurks within. Beware, the card you turn may have a twin. On Card Sharks! And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Curry.
Thank you very much. I thank you. You're very kind. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you. And we would like to thank Lamont Cranston for the opening. No, he didn't do that. That was, you remember that? Wanda Barron from Menlo Park, California, watching us on KRON-TV, Channel 4. Thank you, Wanda. Now let's open up the board and get to the cards. Janice and Lois, if you will, start loading in the cards. We have a game in progress with these card sharks. Bill Demme and our champion. Hi, Bill.
How you doing, Jim?
Good to see you again.
Pleasure to be back.
Won't you again tell us about yourself?
My name is Bill Demme. I'm a retired Los Angeles police officer. I am married, have two children. I now live in Acton, California, where I raise racing mules. In my spare time, I play golf.
Did they let you have the beard when you were on the Los Angeles Police Department?
No, they didn't.
No? You like it now?
I love it.
You look good. Nice to have you back here with us, Bill. And our challenger is Pam Miller. Hi, Pam. Nice to see you again.
Thank you.
And again, a little reminder about you, please.
Okay. My name is Pam Miller, and I am from Temecula, California. I am married, and I have two cute little boys, and I have my little girl on the way. She's going to be here in August.
Are you sure? Have you taken those tests?
No, but I'm convincing myself.
Oh, you think the power of positive thinking will do
so,
that,
I hope so, because I wouldn't know what to do with another boy.
Oh, don't want another one. You're from one of those towns. Temecula sounds like the tape jumped or something when you say that. That doesn't sound right. Nice to have you back here.
Thank
now, you both cut the cards at the beginning of the match,
we
right?
Yes, we did.
And we'll pick up where we left off. We play the best two games out of three. And looking at the board, Bill has uncovered an eight as his base card, needs four cards. Pam has moved over. She also has an eight, but she needs only one for the first game of the match. We pick up with question three, and it goes to you, Bill. Bill, we asked 100 marriage counselors. Generally speaking, are most couples who get divorced just taking the easy way out? How many marriage counselors said most couples who get divorced are taking the easy way out?
I think that's a pretty high number. I agree. I know a lot of people that have been divorced, and they just couldn't sit down and work out their problems. So the number is going to be 64.
64 out of 100 marriage counselors said, yeah, most of them are taking the easy way out. Pam, higher or lower?
No, Jim, I don't think they're taking the easy way out. I think if they can't get along, they shouldn't be together. So I'm going to have to go just a little bit lower on that.
So you say lower. And of course, not too much agreement with the audience. Yes. Really, what it comes down to is, should they talk more about it or drop it? Let's find out. Bill says 64. Pam says lower. The actual number of marriage counselors who said most couples who get divorced are taking the easy way out is 37. Pam is right. It is lower.
Yeah.
Interesting. Pam, we left off with an eight.
I want to change that card, Jim.
Whenever you win the question, you have the right
Come
to
on.
Change
Good
the base card.
Oh.
Right up the middle.
I'm going to call it lower.
If this is lower,
Come
Pam
on.
Is the first game of the match for the win.
Oh.
It's not lower. And Bill is still in it, looking at an eight to call this. Lower. Lower than an eight. That one is a seven.
I'm going to freeze.
And we move over the freeze bar that protects that position. Janice will fill in the space for Pam, where it's sudden death. Someone has to win the game on this play of the cards. Pam, we asked 100 first grade kids, is there a monster that lives in your room and only comes out when the lights are off? How many first graders said, yeah, there is a monster who lives in the room and only comes out in the dark?
Well, I know a lot of little kids are pretty scared of the dark, but I don't think there's really a monster there as far as they're concerned.
How many believe there is?
Oh, let me say about 35.
35 out of 100 say, yeah, when it gets dark,
no,
here comes the monster.
It's going to be lower. I have a five-year-old, and he doesn't believe in monsters in the dark.
You figure they're more realistic than that.
Right, it's going to be lower.
So Bill says lower, and the actual number of first graders who said there is a monster who lives in the room and only comes out when it's dark is 43, not lower. Well, that's interesting. More than believe it. Pam, it is sudden death. You have an eight. You could, of course, change it if you like and try to turn over one card. Bill with a seven needs three. You have control. Play or pass.
I am going to let Bill play it.
All right, Bill.
Thank you.
Turn them all over. You win the game. One mistake. It belongs to Pam with a seven. What do you say?
We've got to go higher, Jim.
Higher than a seven? No, it's not. Pam wins it in sudden death. So it is game one to the challenger at $100. We will set up for game two coming at you right after this. Finally got over there.
Alan, Bert, Jim, Bob. Alan, Bert, Jim, Bob. Password plus, super password tattletales. Card sharks, the buzzard daytime tango starts weekdays at 2.
Wow.
On Buzzer.
Ready to start game 2. Same 2 decks of cards. Janice deals out the next cards off the top of the deck. Before we start game 2, we have a group with us here in the audience. So we're here the first time we taped Card Sharks, the Van Nuys Senior Citizens Group. Boy, you brought us luck. Tonight, happy to have you back. Okay, we start game 2. Bill, you need it. And we start with a question to you.
All right.
Bill, we asked 100 millionaires, have you ever bought something you didn't really need just to get your parking ticket validated? How many millionaires have bought something they didn't need just so the store would validate their parking ticket?
Well, I think there's going to be a few of them that did, but not too many. The number's going to be fairly low. I'd say 24.
24 out of 100 millionaires. What do you think, Ben?
Well, I know rich people. They have money, but I think a lot of them are pretty cheap. But I think that's got to be a little bit lower, though.
You say lower.
Yeah. Yeah.
Richard, what's cheap, buying something to avoid the ticket or paying the ticket? Oh. You say lower, Ben. Bill says 24. The actual number of millionaires who bought something they didn't need just to get their parking ticket validated is 4. That's all. Just 4. Ben, you got it.
Come on, Ben. Good card.
For a very silly millionaire, I mean, to buy a Rolls Royce just so you don't have to buy a ticket. That's my goodness. Pam, you start off with a king.
All right. Lower.
Lower than a king. A 6.
Freeze.
Don't want to take a chance.
Chicken?
No, not necessarily. Maybe good strategy. Pam, some congressmen have criticized the president's cutoff of grain shipments to Russia because they feel it will not really hurt the Soviet Union. So we asked 100 people, do you think the president took a strong enough stand against the Russians? How many people think the president did take a strong enough stand against the Russians?
Well, the way things are going right now, a lot of people think that the president isn't doing much of anything right now, and they'd like him to do a heck of a lot more. But I don't know about that. I'm going to go 50 on that.
50?
Yeah.
50 out of 100 say yes, they think the president did take a strong enough stand against the Russians, cutting off the grain.
I think the number is going to be higher. People in general think that they should have cut more off going to Russia.
So how many think that he did take a strong enough stand? She says 50.
The number is going to be lower then.
You say lower then.
Not enough.
All right.
Right.
Sounds like that's where your thinking was going, Bill. Okay. Let's find out now. The actual number of people who think the president did take a strong enough stand against the Russians is 39. Bill is right.
Yeah.
It is lower.
All right.
Yes. Moore thought he should have done more. And Bill starts with a queen.
Good. Lower.
Lower than the queen. A 3.
Higher.
Higher than a 3. Oh, no. Back to the base guard goes Bill. Pam, a break for you with a 6.
I got
to
go higher.
Higher than the 6? No. Another 6 is not higher. Janice has a lot of spaces to fill in. Question 3, Bill. Bill, we asked 100 secretaries. If your boss asked you to type a letter and you knew it was full of lies, would you refuse to do it? How many secretaries would refuse to type a letter if they knew it was full of lies?
I don't think too many secretaries would refuse to type it because it would probably mean their job. They would go ahead and type it. I'd say 60 would type it.
So how many would refuse to type it?
All right, 40.
40. 40 out of 100. He remembers his math, Pam.
I have to go lower on that because a secretary's job does involve things like that. They have to do it. So I'm going to have to go lower with
you. You say lower than that. The actual number of secretaries who would refuse to type a letter if they knew it was full of lies is 25. You're right, Pam. It is lower. And Bill, you're probably right. There are 25 out there looking for a job. You've got a 6, Pam.
I want to change that.
And the 6 becomes a 10.
Oh, I got to go lower.
Lower than the 10. Yes, a 7.
Freeze.
And Pam needs just 2 cards for the championship. Sudden death once again. Pam, we asked 100 bachelors. Does someone, somewhere, have a love letter you wrote that you'd give anything to get back? How many bachelors said someone does have a love letter they'd give anything to get back?
Well, I imagine a lot of them have the love letters, but I don't think they'd really want to get it back because it was something that they had written probably a long time ago. So I'm going to say 30.
30 out of 100 say, yeah, there's a letter around they want to get back.
It's going to be lower than that, Jim. Like Pam says, a lot of guys have written these letters, but they're not too concerned about
them. They don't want them back.
No, that's going to be lower.
Yeah, well, we'll find out. Actually, the ones who want it back, probably it's the original that they mimeograph, friends. Like, Pam says 30, Bill says lower. The actual number of bachelors who said someone does have a love letter they'd give anything to get back again is 21. Bill is right. It is lower. Well, Bill, you've got control, but you've got a bit of a problem. Do you want to try to turn over four cards or force Pam with two?
I'm going to pass it to Pam and let her do it.
All right, Pam, get them both to the new champion. One mistake, we've got a tie.
Come on, Jim. I want that card. Come on.
Higher than a seven? No, it's not higher. Still ties it up in sudden death. So now, each player with one game and $100, we set up for the tiebreaker. And game three, just three cards up there, three questions here. This decides who goes for the big money. Bill, the question to you. Bill, we asked 100 third grade boys, when you're playing, is it more fun being the good guy or the bad guy? How many third grade boys said it's more fun being the bad guy?
That's going to be a low number. Like, I have a couple of boys, and they like playing the bad guy.
Well, how many say that it's more fun being the bad guy? That's a good answer, Bill. Yes. Let me give it to you again. You seem to be having some problem there. How many third grade boys said it's more fun being the bad guy than the good guy?
Oh, I'd say that's a fairly high number. I'd say 65.
65 out of 100 want to be the bad guy, Pam. What do you think?
Oh, I don't know. I'd say probably half of them might want to be the bad guy and half of them might want to be the good guy. So I'm going to go lower.
You say lower. The actual number of third grade boys who said it's more fun being the bad guy is 34. Pam is right. It is lower.
Come on.
And starts off in a 10.
Change it, please.
Big change with just three cards. A king.
Lower.
Lower than a king. A three.
Higher.
We have a new champion. If it's higher, yes. Well, Bill, we have to say goodbye. And you won a couple of $100, and of course we have some nice party gifts for you, Bill.
Thank you.
Good luck with the racing mules.
All right, thank
Bill
you.
Bill Vivian. Pam Miller, come on down here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Pam Miller, our new champion, $200 richer. She's going for a whole lot more right after we take time out for this.